Dream of getting questions. So, whatever goes, whatever you think, from the funny mark of the forehead to why we fell from the spiritual world.
sorry,
don't mind me. Go ahead.
I Googled you guys.
Ah, yes, Google, okay. Google, Bhagavan, Wacha.
Yes. I found a few very strange things. I found a few pictures of elephant gods and fish gods, and even pig gods.
Well, okay. Let me explain this. It's really, our philosophy has been misrepresented a lot throughout the ages, especially in modern media. But it's really very simple. Krishna consciousness is a process where you come to understand who you really are. Because right now, everyone is chasing an illusion that there's happiness in this world, where happiness does not exist. But happiness does exist. It exists back in the spiritual world with God, with Krishna. And we can go there by chanting a Hare Krishna mantra. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama. Rama, Rama, Hari, Hari. Very simple.
So do you think that your religion is the only way to break illusion and that every other religion is wrong?
No. We don't say that. Especially me. I'm like lower than the straw on the street.
I'm sorry, I don't understand.
Lower than the cigarette butt in the pavement?
Oh.
What? Yes. Okay, so basically, we say that anyone can transcend this illusion by taking this process.
Okay. And I mean, this chanting that you talk about, it's kind of like a meditation?
Exactly. That's what it is. Do you think you might like to give it a try yourself?
Oh, me?
Yeah. No. Oh, Hare Krishna Maharaj. Who have you got here? Well, this nice lady, Maharaj, she came with a few questions, and I was just telling her about the chanting. Oh, are you interested in the chanting?
I don't think so. It's a bit too strange for me.
It may seem strange at the start, but in fact, there's nothing more natural to the soul than to chant God's names in ecstasy.
Yeah, that's a bit too wild for me, but do you maybe have some kind of program or something that I could come to?
Absolutely. Just tomorrow we have our Sunday program where we have a bit of a discussion, talk on philosophy, and then after that we have some singing, dancing, and then everyone's favorite part, the wonderful free vegetarian meal. So, You should come. Give her a card.
Yes. All the details you need to know will be found here.
That's amazing. Well, thank you very much. I guess I'll see you guys tomorrow.
Yes. Yeah, see you then.
Thank you.
See, hope so.
Bye.
Thank you very much.
Bye
bye.
Bye
bye.
This scene was meant to demonstrate a modern day temple experience in ISKCON. However, the Hare Krishna movement is an eternal one. It exists in all times, present, past, and future. Let us go back in time and see this very same scene in 16th century England, in ISKCON, Stratford-on-Avon.
Good morrow. Anyone afoot?
Hark! Who is it there that goes before mine eye?
A mere peasant, coming with eyes and ears wide to learn of the good tidings thou might speak it of.
Well, Hare Krishna from Eden. Please, come in and sit me down upon this pretty cushion soft. Hare.
Wouldst thou protest, kind sir, if I might inquire from thee?
Wouldst I protest? Wouldst I protest? Nay, my lady! As the duck takes to water, Hare Krishnas take to questions. Let your lips bring forth rivers and mountains of words that shall fall upon my ever eager ears.
Pray tell, my lord. I have oft heard of those that speak it to bury thee to the ground rather than to praise thee. What sayest thou of this?
It is not a surprise, my lady. It is not a surprise at all. And thinkest thou what thou will. But if the blind man is to extol the glories of darkness, would thou no longer seek the warm embrace of the sun's spray upon thy flesh? By my troth, I know not a sweeter taste of confectionery than this life I hereby now live. As the good book says, all the world's a stage, and all the men and women merely players, be they Dutchmen or Germans, Croats or Slovaks. We seek he who is the very essence of sweetness. And calling out in love, we seek to yoke ourselves to him. We call out, Krishna! Krishna! Wherefore art thou, O Krishna? Deny thy Maya and rejoice in thy name.
So thou is an illusion nevermore?
Alas, poor Maya. I knew her too well.
And thus, thou dost chant with thine God in mind?
Forsooth, my lady, thou hast understood so well. Will thou now take to the chanting of the Lord's holy name and see the path of the divine heavens open up before me to the Almighty God? My lady? My lady?
To chant or not to chant? That is the question. Whether it is nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous karma or to take arms against it? Methinks not. Methinks not.
Aye, there's the rub. Will this chanting be like a dagger to thy chest? Oh, Hare Krishna, your lordship. Boo-hoo!
Oh, what?
Now, that cometh into view.
Perhaps a wandering jiva? This fair maiden?
Indeed.
She come bearing questions, my lord. Speaking to her now of the divine glories of the Lord's holy name? Hark, poor souls. There is nothing in the divine stars more brilliant and more beautiful than the Lord's pure holy names. Thou hast interest too?
I know not, my lord, but hast thou some right I shall perchance bring myself for?
On the morrow, thou shalt bliss thou shalt find with song, dance, and veggies sanctified. Thou fair lady, thou senses shall bombard. Pray tell, Prabhu, present her with a car.
My lady, everything you can find shall be here forthwith.
Thank you, kindly. A bit you both come.
I know, my lady, and all.
Very nicely.
Let us now move forward in time to the 19th century and see the same scene, but this time in ISKCON, Texas, and the wild, wild west.
I've heard some pretty mighty fine strings. about you, Hare Krishnas. Now what are you all about? Are you all as bad as they say you are?
I'll tell you, Missy, that is lies! Anyone but the damn lies! Ever since I became the Hare Krishna devotee, I've been happier than a banana dipped in chicken flour! Fralingi! As the good book says, this whole world ain't none but a mirage in the desert. And all those folks wander on down the saloon for their Christian women, thinking they got a good life. They ain't got a good life. We know the good life, the pure life. And that means we sat in the names of the Almighty God who we call Krishna.
So you're saying you got all them answers that nobody else got? Is that what you're saying then, mister?
I ain't saying that, missy. Yeah, missy, I'm lord of the tumbleweed on the street.
And this chanting? That's the mighty strange things that they do in far off lands called meditation.
You got it right then, missy. Hey. You figure you might take some chance of yourself there, missy?
I don't rightly know that. Sure, I don't know.
Why don't you know? Oh, hey, Harry, Trish, show! Let's go!
Hare Krishna to you too, Kaboo! Who that little fella?
She asked a question, Sheriff.
You done told about Maya?
You?
You done told about Krishna?
Yeah?
You done told about chanting?
Yeah? You think you might take to that chanting, missy?
Well, I don't rightly know that, Chef. But I'm thinking I might mosey on up to one of your services sometime, if that's all right.
You betcha. Right tomorrow, we're gonna have some wonderful hootin' tomorrow night after sundown.
Yeah! Then we're gonna have some little singing and some dancing. We're gonna have a good old time. After which, we're gonna have some mighty fine food, which is 100% kettle free.
Yeah!
Partner. Call, would you?
Here you go, missy! Everything you need to know, right there!
Thank you kindly. Good day,
missy!
We move forward yet again and see the same scene in the 1970s in ISKCON, California, USA.
Are you coming in? Hare Krishna, this is the Hare Krishna temple. We chant Hare Krishna here. You know George Harrison chants Hare Krishna?
Oh, like, From the Beatles?
Yeah, that's it.
Cool. So, would you mind if I, like, get down and, like, ask you some questions?
Yeah, okay, take a seat. Krishna says the Bhagavad Gita, Tatmini Puripatena, Paripatena Sevaya, Patekisantike Ganam, Yaminas Tatvadarchiha. Just try to shoot by approaching the spiritual master, quite submissively, and render service on him, self realized souls, part of knowledge of you, because it is the truth. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna,
Krishna.
Cool.
But, like, can I ask you a few questions, though?
Okay, yes, go ahead.
So, like, man, I, like, heard some pretty far-out weird things about you guys.
Demons! Demons! They're all just envious demons. They're trying to find fault with Hare Krishna's because they're a Maya. And you would be too, and if you chant Hare Krishna. George Harrison does.
Well, like, from the Beatles?
Yeah.
Wait, like, Maya's illusion. So, does that mean that everyone is an illusion except for, like, the Hare Krishna?
Yep.
Exactly.
Everyone's pretty Maya except the Hare Krishna. You got it. And you would be too unless you chant Hare Krishna. George has a chance.
Well, like, from the Beatles? Wait, I don't think I'm ready though. Like, I don't want to chat.
You're a rascal! George, have some chance, Hare Krishna. Oh, Hare Krishna Maharaj! That's a cop out to the beast trap, you must be in the middle of the show! Hare Krishna Maharaj! Hare Krishna Maharaj!
Who do we have here?
A wandering jiva. From the ocean of Peter Burton Depp Maharaj. She doesn't want to chant. She wants to stay in Maya.
In Maya? Why would you want to stay in Maya? This body's but a bag of pus, bones, blood, stool and urine. In this place, it's but a place of birth, death, old age and disease. And, I mean, you know, Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Dukkhayam Shashvatam. Do you know George Harrison chants Hare Krishna?
That's like completely new information. Hey, like, so do you guys have some program I could, like, come and like connect you with?
For sure. Right tomorrow we have our Sunday love feast. But we need to get you ready. We need to bring her to the back and put a sari on her, yeah? Okay, Maharaj. Okay. Come on, Manaji. Come on. Get a sari.
Shave her up while you're at it.
Maharaj! It's a Manaji! Shave her up anyway.
We move forward yet again to a mere 20 more years at ISKCON anywhere.
Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Hello?
Hello?
Is anybody here?
Let us now move forward one last time into the future and see how we might deal with guests in the year 2075.
Hey Siri, Gary? Could you do a security background check on that guest outside? There's no known security issues. Let them in for the standard decontamination process, please. Hare Krishna, welcome.
Hello. I have come for information update about the Hare Krishnas.
Thank you. Please, come in. Take a seat.
I have no need to sit. My energy levels are at 82%.
Just take a seat. So, what can I tell you about the Hare Krishnas?
I know everything there is to know about the Hare Krishnas. I have downloaded your app.
Yes, the wonderful ISKCON app. Ever since Google introduced built-in chips to the brain, with constant stream, questions have become a thing of the past. But please, you have a question, please. What is your question?
My question is, why?
Why what?
Why anything? I have so much knowledge, yet I don't know why I exist.
Yes. Well, this is what Krishna consciousness explains, you see. What it tells us is who we really are, as eternal parts and parcels of God. But right now, we're all thinking we're the controllers and the enjoyers. And there are so many problems, because everyone's under this illusion.
I have no illusion. I have access to all knowledge available.
You see, that's the problem. That's what everybody thinks. But let me ask you a simple question. Are you happy?
Happy, adjective, feeling or expressing pleasure or content. No.
Well, there you go. That's the symptom of the problem, see? Because everyone is under these illusions and so much problems of conflict. There's just no one's happy. But happiness does exist. It exists back in the spiritual world, with God, with Krishna, where it's ever expanding.
Can I go there? I want to go there.
Yes, you can go there, but there's a process to it. And the way we do it is by chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra.
Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. I don't feel anything.
Well, you see, that's because, oh, Hare Krishna Maharaj.
Yes, you should not just chant, but you should chant with feeling. As our founder Acharya, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada said,
I have already spent a lot of the
Then you're in for a treat. None of this digitally synthesized dehydrated flakes. This stuff's real. It's cooked on real stoves.
So let's come along. Let's get some. Because specifically, I've heard tonight we have real paneer pakoras made from real milk from real cows.
I feel something has changed. I feel happy. And I feel human.
Our program.